Is it working? Okay, hi guys, and welcome back some more with vlogs with caramida9. Hopefully this time my nipples are well and covered and we're not going to have any problems with censorship and nudity material just like last time. And let us get on with what we're going to do today. So, what I have planned to do for today, I'm not sure if I've done it into a proper video before. I think I might have talked about it in like multiple videos and replied to you guys in the comments about things that I do about this. But basically, you remember that a few weeks ago I did a setup video in which I presented you like the stuff that I have around that I use to like, that the workplace that I have basically, my computer, my webcam, my headphones, my old microphone. Now I have a new one and all that. But I don't think I've ever properly presented you the software that I use. So I decided to just dedicate this video to doing that. It's going to be not a hardware setup video, but a software setup video in which I present you and give you a few basic details about the software that I use for basic recording and editing tools. So let's get on right to it. Alright, so I have all the programs in order on my bar over here down below. We're going to start with the first one. The program that I mostly use for like recording videos and the gameplay is Fraps. It's a pretty good program. This option is currently turned on because I need to record the entire screen and therefore I need to activate this. But usually it should be turned off and Fraps should automatically detect the game screen basically. In case it doesn't, in case you're playing like some flash games that where it doesn't properly detect them, that's what you have to play. You have multiple options around here and there. For example, where you want them to save, where you want the overlay. This is the overlay over here. It shows exactly how many frames there are detected. And when it's red, it means that it's currently recording. If it's yellow, it's like on standby. You can also choose to like, this is also an important setting. You can choose whether or not to record the microphone as well. I have it unchecked because I record the microphone from a different program, a different software. But in case you don't have that, you'll have to tick this in order to like record it. And if you want to change it, then make sure to untick it. Otherwise, you'll have like two microphone inputs and it can overlay. There are a bunch of options here and there. This is the setup that I use. I'm not exactly 100% sure it's the best one. You can mingle around with the options, and you can also take screenshots with the Fraps. The biggest the most important advice that I must give you before using Fraps, and that I always give to everyone on comments or everyone else, is that the files that are made by Fraps are extremely big. So yeah, they're just like very big. Fraps what basically does is like, imagine like you have 60 frame, a game that is running in 60 frames per second, and you have like a full HD camera taking a picture of each and every frame and then putting them together. So that results in like gigantic file sizes. So you must make sure that you have a pretty clear disk space if you want to use this for recording. You don't have to, it's just a suggestion, but it's one of the maybe not the best software out there. In my opinion, technically would be the best because I mostly use this. But anyway, that's one of them. Let's get moving. Another software that I use, hey, over here I am, is this one. The Windows Live Movie Maker, I think it's called. This is what I use for like recording my webcam and my microphone. I don't know. I had this thing planned before, how I'm going to talk, but I'm like completely busted up. But yeah, this is what I basically use for my webcam and my microphone. It's pretty good and it's decent. It's I think it's free if I remember correctly, and it also has some very basic editing implemented into it, so you can go around and actually make videos right ahead from this thing if you want to. You can like edit your basic videos if you film them, either with your webcam, or you can also like upload videos into it from like a different source and try and editing them around. They have a few very basic features, so you know, if you are interested into that, you can start off with this. But yeah, there is much more into it, so let's keep on going. Now for the editing itself, I mostly use Sony Vegas Pro, and I'm not sure if this is the last version, but it's I think it's the version that I currently have right now installed. I haven't updated it in a long while, so there might be some newer versions out there if you're interested. I just have some videos that I haven't really done, I haven't really processed yet, so you know, I'm just putting them up here just to like show you how things are done, and this is just my giant face around here. But yeah, this and Adobe Premiere Pro, I think it's called, are like the best software to be used for editing. They are very simple to use. Obviously, there are a lot of buttons everywhere, and it's going to take you a little bit of time until you get used to it. But it's like, it's very intuitive to use, you know, and it has very high quality potential. You know, you can mess around with like different volumes, you can split the videos in like different parts however you like them, you can ungroup it, you know, and like keep only the video or keep only the audio, or keep the video and the audio. You can like change them around, you know, put them in different order. You can, as you see, like overlay them or put the camera wherever you want. You can even make special effects from here and put it somewhere else. And as you run around, you will see how it
right now, this is a
moves around. That's fine. Grab, right, and yeah, that's the thing that I mostly use. There are a few options that you'll have to do before, a few basic like setup things that you'll have to do before starting to use it, regarding like some settings and also the rendering settings. I'm going to show you what I use just in case you're curious. This is the one that I use, the Internet HD 1080p. Obviously, you can create your own custom template for rendering, and there are many more that you can use depending on what kind of videos you want to do. I suggested checking out other videos that explain properly how these things are done, because obviously I'm not, I'm just not the best thing at this. So just don't just take my word, you know, even if you like what I do, even if you like trust me, don't just take my word. There are tons of tutorials on how to use Sony Vegas, and there are still some issues with the program here and there, so you might as well check those out and figure out on things out on your own. Or you can also go for Adobe Premiere Pro, but I cannot give you any advice on that because I don't use that program. Anyway, moving along. Alright, so a couple of more programs that I want to show you around here. Another one that I've been using mostly for live streams, but that can also be used for recording, is this one. It's called Open Broadcasting Software, or OBS. It's extremely good and very popular for streamers and for even for YouTubers alike, because it is free. It is 100% completely free. It is still in development, and yeah, you still have to like check for updates, and there might be some incomplete features, but it is pretty good, you know. You have to add up sources. I'm going to explain it a little bit how it works. You basically have to add the sources that you want to record. There are different kind of sources, like the video capture devices refers mostly to webcam. The game capture refers to like software of games that you want to capture. In case you cannot detect them, you can use window capture to like capture like a different certain part of the window, or you know, you can just insert certain text. There's even more. You can add them from over here, like images, slideshow, and monitor capture. It also has a preview feature right over here, and you can see how the volume is going. And I'm not exactly sure why the webcam is not present. It should have been, but I guess it's asking too much for that. I really don't know what's up with that. So as I said, I'm not really the best at using this software. And yeah, if you want to go for live streams, you'll have to go and check out the broadcasting settings, check like choose where you want to live stream, and also insert like the stream key or whatever, which is very important that you don't reveal it. Otherwise, other people could live stream on your channel and get yourself banned. So, you know, it's It's a pretty neat software, and I totally recommend for UCG if you are new to either recording or live streaming. All right, so moving along. Okay, so one more program that I wanted to show you is called, I think, Handbrake. I don't have it installed anymore, but I had it at some point. It's basically just a basic video compression file, which is once again free. It is very good, and I used it a lot when you know, I had like my old computer and my old internet. Sometimes the file that I would render, they would be like too big and it would take too long to upload, and therefore you can use Handbrake to like compress those files to like have smaller size, and it doesn't lose that much quality. So yeah, it's a pretty good thing. Obviously I can't even remember how you used it. I'd have to like download it and like reread some of the tutorials or rewatch them or anything like that. But it's another software that I have used, and I just wanted to recommend it to you over here. And I think apart from that, there was also another program that I have never used, but I have seen other people use it. I think it was called Audacity. And this one is for like audio recording, I think. But yeah, apparently it's also a free open source audio software, and it also allows for multi-track recording. I might get into it, you know, I'm not exactly sure. I have seen it, and at some point I think I had it installed, but I just never used it, you know. And that's just about all my experience that I have with recording and editing. So yeah, hope it was a learning experience for you guys. Hope you got a better insight about what I use to record and edit. And as always, leave a like and a subscribe, helps a lot. And I'll see you next time with what are you going to make. Bye bye.